Well, I was inspecting a Thor Love and Thunder trailer today. That's for sure. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the channel. Once again, I am Robert Storms. As always, if you guys are finding me for the very first time, please do me a big favor. Smash that thumbs up and subscribe button. That way you guys can stay up to date on all future content here on the channel. Also, shameless plug, guys. If you guys can go over to my Robert Storms Gaming channel, I would very much appreciate it. Trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. I do everything like I do here on this channel. I do trailer reactions, reviews, breakdowns, news, even live streams. Right now I'm going through the Kingdom Hearts game for its 20th anniversary. Live streaming that. Got 8 parts up right now. But please, guys, go over there. I will have the link in the description box below, as well as a pinned comment in the comment section. And if you guys can go over there and subscribe to help me reach my goal of 1,000 subscribers, I would very much appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much for everything. So the Thor Love and Thunder trailer hit earlier this morning, about 15 minutes ago. I was searching the web, wasn't expecting to see anything like that. I'm like, well, what am I going to talk about today? And originally I was going to talk about the possible Snyderverse reboot or even Batman now on HBO Max. And then I seen the Thor Love and Thunder trailer and I'm like, well, obviously I'm going to have to talk about this. So let's do a trailer reaction to that. So without further ado, guys, I'm going to shut the hell up and we're going to watch the Thor Love and Thunder trailer and we're going to talk about it right after the reaction. Okay, let's talk about this. Let's jump into it. Ready, guys? Let's fire this thing up.
Hands were once used for battle. Now they're but humble tools for peace. I need to figure out exactly.
Oh, he's dead again. Okay, now he's working out to get fit again.
I want to choose my own path. Live in the moment. Superheroing days are over.
That's gonna be a montage at the beginning of the movie. This is gonna be so copyrighted right now.
Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost? Just look into the eyes of the people that you love.
Me?
What? Just listening.
Okay, all right, so let's talk about that, I guess. I'm still trying to process the trailer, guys. I'm sorry. Still trying to process the trailer. Obviously, it leads off where Endgame, or starts where Endgame leaves off with Thor with, you know, the Guardians, and he's getting in shape and all that, and he kind of lost his way. He's like, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do. My hero days are past, blah, blah, blah. Like, just kind of lost his way. And then we see at the end, Jane, Natalie Portman, who is going to be the female Thor, and she has Mjolnir, and it's like all put together again, right? Like it's no longer shattered. It's put together again. I didn't know you could do that with Mjolnir, but whatever. So I don't know. I'm just kind of curious on that one. I don't know. There's not, I don't know because I read the first, you know, 5 issues of female Thor, you know, when Jane Foster and all this stuff, and who was she, and then you found out she had cancer and all this stuff. I read all that, but this trailer, for the most part, and here's the problem that I have. Here's the problem that I have. For the first, like, this whole trailer, all we saw was Thor, right? We saw Thor that we all know for this whole trailer, right? But everything that we see in that trailer could easily be the first 10 to 15 minutes of that movie. And then it just completely just bait and switches you, and then it's completely just Natalie Portman's movie for the rest of the film. And maybe Jane is dying of cancer in this movie. Who knows? I don't know which story route they're going. And could she possibly help Thor get that fire back to become Thor again? I don't know. I don't know which way they're going to take this. This could easily be really good, but just as bad could be really bad and very preachy and very, you know, hit you over the head. Me too, me too, me too. And I don't know. So I'm going to stay on a positive note and be like, overall, I thought the trailer was fine. Nothing in this trailer blew me away. I'm still very much looking forward to the movie because I love Thor Ragnarok. I like Taika Waititi as a director. So I'm definitely interested in seeing what he does with this property and female Thor. And I want to see what they do with it. You see Valkyrie, she's in a business suit. Like, I don't know if it's a lawyer or what she's doing. I don't know how she gets a degree when she never even went to school. But that's, you know, it's a movie, whatever. Let's try not talking about that. But you see where Thor just kind of lost his way after Endgame. And he's trying to build himself back up, lose weight and all this. And then at the end, we see Jane Foster for the first time as Thor. So, like I said, from the looks of it, it very well could be everything we've seen with Thor is the first 10 to 15 minutes of this movie. And it's all like montage and stuff. And because you know Guardians aren't going to play a huge role in this movie. It's going to be the first 10 to 15 minutes of this movie. That's just my speculation on it, guys. I have no insider information. It's just me giving an educated guess. I could be 100% wrong. It's just what I'm seeing right now and what I'm kind of looks like to me. But anyway, guys. That's all I have. Before I go, once again, if you guys can go over there and subscribe to my gaming channel, I will have the description, or I will have the link in the description box below, as well as a pinned comment. If you guys can just go ahead and subscribe, help me get to 1,000 subscribers, I would appreciate that. Well, guys, what did you guys think about the Thor trailer? Leave those comments in the comment box below. Smash that like and subscribe button. Are you looking forward to the movie? Did you like the trailer? Leave all those comments below. Until next time, as always, I am Robert Storms, and that's my opinion.